نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. وأشهد أن نبينا وقدوتنا وإمامنا قدوة الخلائق أجمعين وسيد ولد آدم أجمعين محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. عباد الله، أوصي نفسي وإياكم بتقوى الله عز وجل ولزوم طاعته والحرص على سنة نبيكم صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال عز من قائل سبحانه: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. ثم اعلموا أن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة في دين الله بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. وقانا الله وإياكم شر الفتن وشر الضلال وشر النيران آمين. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every single one of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds to help us to worship Him as He likes, as He wants. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right path to follow our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the right way. Dear respected brothers, as I spoke last week about the virtues of Sha'ban, I said this night, this today, I will speak about what we have to know about the middle night of Sha'ban. The middle of the night, the night of the middle of Sha'ban, which is coming, inshallah, the next night, the Saturday after Maghrib. But let me clarify at the beginning of this khutbah about one of the fundamental rules of Islam, the basic rules of Islam called Usul al-Fiqh. One of the rules of Islam, which all our Islam depends on, in Arabic says, al-ibadatu tawqifiyya. What does mean al-ibadatu tawqifiyya? Any worship depends on the and evidence. The evidence. Without evidence, stop. Don't worship, don't follow any ibadah except if you have the evidence to word, to work, to act, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us everything through our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't to do in his life will not be as a worship for us. How can to invent some ibadah, some worship without any evidence? This is what called the bid'ah, something not related to the Prophet ﷺ, even to his companions after him. Why I am saying that? Because the night of the middle of Sha'ban has many, many different saying and many, many different opinion between some people know one of them as a scholar. But the majority of scholars said there is no any an authentic hadith about this night of the middle of Sha'ban. The majority of scholars. Except some scholars, they made one hadith from this hadith, they found it an authentic hadith. And I agree with them, definitely this hadith sahih. We will depend on this hadith to tell you what we can learn from this hadith today, inshaAllah ta'ala. This hadith narrated by Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says in the nearest meaning, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَطَّلِعُ عَلَىٰ جَمِيعِ خَلْقِهِ فِي لَيْلَةِ النِّصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِجَمِيعِ خَلْقِهِ إِلَّا لِمُشْرِكٍ أَوْ مُشَاحٍ. This hadith عند Ibn Majah. This hadith says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking to His creations at the night of the middle of Sha'ban. And already Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing this every night. Many, many hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tell us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yanzil nuzulan yaliqu bi jalalihi subhanahu wa ta'ala at the third part of the night, every night, to say, هل من سائل? Is there anybody to ask him something? I give you him. This every night, especially this night. The Prophet ﷺ says in this hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yattali'u ala khalqih. And this is karam. This is something honor for us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to look at our actions, our ibadah, our hearts. And you will know why Allah says yattali'u ala ibadihi. In other hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرْ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَا أَبْدَانِكُمْ. Allah doesn't look at our bodies or our images. وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَى قُلُوبِكُمْ. Our hearts. وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. Our actions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking to us at the night of the middle of Sha'ban? He will forgive everybody of us. This is glad tidings. Accept. Two kinds of people will not gain the maghfirah, the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why we have to explain this hadith to avoid these things which prevent the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, illa li mushrik aw mushahid. Mushrik means the person who is doing something or associate anything with Allah azza wa jal. And definitely this shirk is two types, as you know. Major shirk, which the person who doing major sins, major shirk, he will be forever in the hellfire. As Allah said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ. Allah never forgive the shirk. وَلَا يَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. But forgive anything else. And other type is minor shirk. And this is also the problem, but it will take our hasanat off. But the rest of hasanat which we do with ikhlas, with sincerity for Allah, it will remain. The shirk asghar, I will not explain more, but I tell you, shirk asghar means to swear by something except Allah, to swear by your dads, by your family, by your friend, by your son. Also, if to do something showing off, to do something from ibadah, for reason of dunya, to worship, to do salah because people are looking to you, or in reason. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give you reward about these actions only. Anyway, this is shirk. And the second, aw mushahid. And this is what I am going to explain a little bit. What does mushahid mean? The person who has in his heart hatred against any Muslim. To hate the Muslims, to hate his brothers, his uncles, his family. Any troubles between you and your family, if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive your sin, the previous sin at this night, you have to clean your heart from now. You have to work with your heart. So the ibadah at this night, not ibadah, not a worship by actions, the ibadah by our hearts. The first, to make all your actions with the ikhlas for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to avoid every type of shirk, to avoid shirk akbar, the major shirk, or the minor shirk, the shirk al-asghar. The first thing, this is, as the scholar says, min a'mal al-qulub, some from the actions of the hearts. A'mal al-qulub al-ikhlas. Also from a'mal al-qulub, the actions of heart, to love for the sake of Allah, to hate as well for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in other hadith, he showed us what is the result of the hatred. If you keep the hatred in your heart, especially during these good days, towards anybody, any Muslim, especially with your family, with your close family, with your dad, your uncles, your aunts, your children, your anybody related to, because it's the first body, the first people will be asked about at the Day of Judgment. The Prophet ﷺ warned us from any hatred in your heart towards any or against any Muslim. He says, دَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ دَاءُ الْأُمَمِ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. The diseases of the previous nations came to you. Al-hasad wal-baghda. Al-hasad means envy and hatred. Came to us and it came to the previous nations. The Prophet said to us to warn us from these bad actions from our heart, because the hasad, the envy, started from our hearts. Not just by your eye or by your tongue, it starts from our heart. If you keep love for your brother in your heart, never will do hasad for him, will do envy, never. Because if you love for me and I love for you, whatever I love for myself, this is the complete iman, the perfect iman. لَا يُؤْمِنْ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى يُحِبَّ لِيَخِيهِ مَا يُحِبُّ لِنَفْسِهِ. You will not be perfect in your faith until to love for me whatever you love for yourself. But if you have clean heart at this night, you will gain the maghfirah, the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, الْحَسَدُ وَالْبَغْضَى إِنَّهَا الْحَالِقَةَ. This is حَالِقَة. حَالِقَة means to take the hair off. لا أقول, the Prophet says, لا أقول تحلق الشعر. This is حسد and بغضاء, envy and hatred. It will not sever the heart, the hair. ولكن تحلق الدين. It will cut the religion. It will sever the religion. If you, I have any hatred against the Muslim, it will take my religion off, out. Subhanallah. So, as a result of your pure heart, to clean your heart, what the Prophet said about it? Look at this story, and everybody, I think, knows this story. This story, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari said, كنا جلوسا عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, we were sitting around the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he said, يدخل عليكم الآن رجل من أهل الجنة. It will enter from this door, a man from the people of Jannah. Everybody looking to the door to see who will enter. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Umar ibn al-Khattab, even they are sitting. Who is this man to deserve this is glad tidings from the Prophet sallam? And a man entered from the door and came. Nobody knows him. Even the scholars didn't mention his name. The Sahabi didn't mention him. Who is this man? But definitely from the people of Jannah. Just he described him, تَقْتُرُ لِحْيَتُهُ مَاءً مِنَ الْمُبُوءِ. Just he came, and some drops of water comes down from his beard. Just, he didn't mention his name. The second day, the third day, 3 days, the Prophet ﷺ says, يَدْخُلُ عَلَيْكُمْ الآن, the man will come. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, one from the close Sahaba to the Prophet ﷺ, according to the actions, he used to follow the Prophet ﷺ step by step. He said, وَاللَّهِ لَأَعْرِفَنَّ, I will know what he is doing, this man, to deserve this position, Jannah. He went to him and he said, oh my uncle, I have something between me and my dad. He didn't say trouble, but to avoid the caliph, he said, something between me and my dad. Can you allow me to stay with you 3 nights, please? He said, okay, come. He went to his house and he stepped with him to see what he is doing, this man, at the night. Maybe he will start the Qiyam Layl, then to pray at night from the Isha to Fajr. Should be something different what I am doing. He didn't find this man doing anything extra what I am doing. Every day, like me. Maybe I am doing more than him. Abdullah ibn Abd al-Bas explained. At the end of 3 days, he said, Ya Abdullah, O slave of Allah, there's no any big issue between me and my dad, but because I heard the Prophet say so and so about you, what are you doing? I didn't find you to do anything more than me. Why the Prophet gave you specially glad tidings about it, about Jannah, only for you 3 days? He said, I have no anything else. This is what I'm doing every day. When Abdullah wanted to go, he said, stop. إلا أنني, but maybe just one thing. لا أنام, I never sleep at night. وفي قلبي شيء على مسلم. I didn't keep anything against the Muslim when I sleep at night. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As says that this is what you have achieved, and this is what we didn't and we couldn't achieve until now. This is the position of Jannah, Allah gave you by this action. Action of what? Not for salah, not for too much siyam. Actions of the hearts. How to keep your heart clean, how to keep your heart pure from people, how to avoid yourself from the envy to hasad for Muslims, how to love each other. Even the Prophet ﷺ, the previous hadith, he said, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَبَبْتُمْ. Shall I give you something? If you do, you will love each other. After salam, spread the peace between you. He said, لَنْ تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ بِيَدِهِ. By Allah, whom my soul between his hands. لَنْ تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا. You will never enter Jannah until to believe, to have the complete iman in your heart. وَلَنْ تُؤْمِنُوا. Your iman will not be perfect until تَحَابُوا. Until to love each other. If I am every day, I'm saying, Alhamdulillah, I am a believer. But everybody around you, when you see you, لا إله إلا الله, this man not good, not okay. This man doing this one, so. Wallahi, never Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will